filmmakers who've been streaming from home are David Gilmour, his wife, the novelist Polly Sampson, and their family, calling themselves, in an ironic tribute to The Sound of Music, the Von Trapped family. Sampson's latest book is set on the Greek island of Hydra in the 1960s, where the colourful, and that's a euphemism, artistic community included the young Canadian singer-songwriter Leonard Cohen and his lover Marianne Elan. David and daughter Romany will be singing the Cohen classic So Long Marianne very shortly. But first, why was Cohen on the island?
It was his first time out of North America. He was a 25-year-old poet who had had one collection of poetry published in Canada. And then on the advice of someone who knew the painter Gika, who had a 40-room mansion on Hydra, he went to Hydra to finish writing his first novel.
And he's kind of living the dream. There are amazing photographs of him on Hydra, looking as if he's having a blissful time.
Yes, I think he did have a blissful time, partly. I mean, there were three people, really, who made that time particularly blissful. One was the very famous Marianne Elan, who, as we know, you know, helped him to actually, in the end, become a songwriter by keeping the house so beautifully, putting a gardenia and a little sandwich on his desk, which is the sort of famous thing that he talks about. But the other people who were very important were a pair of Australian writers, a married couple called George Johnston and Charmian Clift. And he credited them with teaching him everything he knew about writing. It was because he found that writing couldn't really pay the bills that he found himself becoming a songwriter.
But if we think about the song, So Long, Marianne, what's the background to that? Is it the kind of the end of the affair?
Interestingly, So Long, Marianne was originally called Come On, Marianne, which is a very different meaning. And I think she, in her lifetime, found it awful that this song was So Long, Marianne, when she knew that it was Come On, Marianne.
David, how important has Cohen's work been for you?
I mean, I became a fan very early on. I love his work, but it's this last couple of years with Polly, going to Hydra, has freshened him up enormously in my mind.
Well, he hasn't listened to anything but Leonard Cohen for the last few years.
There's a secret.
And he got better and better. I mean, there are songs all the way through his career that are just so brilliant.
Yeah. If there was one song apart from Marianne that you think is just brilliant, Cohen, what would it be?
There's just too many brilliant, brilliant songs right from the last, the very last album that's just come out. Thanks for the Dance. It's just a lovely song. A song called Going Home. There are just too many gorgeous songs.
If It Be Your Will?
If It Be Your Will, yeah. Where he tends towards religious overtones in so many of the things he does, but didn't claim to really believe in a God.
Well, we're looking forward to hearing you and So Long, Marianne. I have to tell you, just as we sign off, that one of my friends said, and it'd be kind of nice to hear Leonard Cohen singing Wish You Were Here, wouldn't it?
Too late for that, I think.
So I'm afraid it's too late. Thanks very much, David and Polly.
Thank you, Barry. Thanks.
Stay tuned just a bit longer to hear Marianne. Next week, I'll be wondering what a visit to the theatre or concert hall will be like in a few months or years' time, with Kwame Kwe-Ama of the Young Vic Theatre, Antonio Papano of the Royal Opera House, and actor Juliet Stevenson. And we'll have another exclusive film from Emma Thompson, this time with Greg Wise. Till then, so long.
Come over to the window, little darling, I'd like to try to read your palm. I used to think that I was some kind of gypsy boy before. place. As we went kneeling through the dark, oh, so long, Marianne, it's time that we began to love and cry and cry and laugh about it all. Wash my